heart failure is a leading cause of morbidity and mortality in the United States. One of the treatments used to manage advanced heart failure is an implantable ventricular assist device known as a VAD. VAD technology has a prominent role in extending and improving the lives of patients with advanced heart failure. In an emergency, being familiar with the skills and protocols necessary to care for patients with VADs is crucial. This video will demonstrate how to assess and care for an unresponsive patient with a VAD without adequate perfusion. Given nuances in the machinery and its interplay with physiology, a basic understanding of these principles will help you provide effective and timely care. You will learn the basics of how to ensure the VAD device is working and how to evaluate the patient following a VAD-specific algorithm, which is included in the most recent ACLS guidelines. You will also learn about complications that are common to patients supported by VAD devices. There are four main components to a VAD system: the pump, the driveline, the controller, and the power supply. The pump provides normal cardiac output to a patient with severe heart failure. It does the work of pumping blood, which the patient's heart can no longer do. The driveline is the connection from the pump to the external equipment. The controller is the brain of the system and monitors the device, allowing the patient and providers to assess the VAD status. The power supply is either from a battery pack or a wall outlet and provides power to the pump. We will now review how to assess the patient following the VAD-specific ACLS algorithm. The focus of this video is on a patient without adequate perfusion, so after the first branch point of this algorithm. The VAD-ACLS algorithm can be broken down into three distinct parts: assessing the VAD, assessing the patient, and proceeding to the ACLS protocol, including CPR when indicated. Remember to always contact the local VAD team as you begin to troubleshoot issues related to the VAD device, as they can provide expert guidance during emergencies. In an unresponsive VAD patient, it is crucial to determine if the device is on and functioning properly. The two main systems currently in use are the HeartMate system, including the HeartMate 2 and the HeartMate 3, and the HeartWare system. Each has a slightly different set of connections, which we will briefly review. When you arrive at the patient's bedside, identify the controller of the VAD and check to see if the device is on. In a patient with a HeartMate device, check to see if the green symbol is illuminated on the controller. If it is, the device is on. If not, here is how to reconnect it. Here is how to reconnect the driveline. And the power supply. For the HeartWare device, check to see if the device is on this screen. If it is off, the screen and lights on the face of the controller will be blank, or it could display connect driveline. Here is how to reconnect the driveline and the power supply. Reconnecting the driveline or power supply quickly will resuscitate the patient if the pump was off. You should next auscultate over the chest to confirm the hum of the VAD. If you auscultate, you will hear a sound something like this. This often masks the normal heart tones. Once you have confirmed that the VAD is on, you should proceed with your primary survey of the patient. The typical ACLS primary survey is more complicated in a patient supported by a VAD. VAD devices are based on a continuous flow of blood, making palpating a pulse difficult, if not impossible. As such, the pulse is not a critical factor in the VAD-ACLS algorithm. However, the blood pressure obtained via a Doppler will be the factor that determines if you proceed with chest compressions and CPR. Blood pressure in VAD patients is best measured using a Doppler device. Electronic blood pressure measuring systems are often inaccurate in VAD patients. However, in the absence of a Doppler device, assessing the patient's skin color and capillary refill in conjunction with the blood pressure obtained without a Doppler can still be useful. Here is how to obtain a blood pressure using the Doppler device. With the blood pressure cuff in place, put the Doppler over the brachial or radial artery. You will hear a swishing sound like this. Inflate the cuff until you hear the swishing sound disappear. Inflate the cuff a little higher, then begin to slowly deflate. The first sound you hear via the Doppler is the Doppler blood pressure and is roughly equivalent to the mean arterial pressure. A Doppler blood pressure of less than 50 millimeters of mercury is a flowless arrest and indicates poor forward flow and inadequate tissue perfusion. If blood pressure is less than 50, begin CPR. If the patient is already intubated and their end-tidal CO2 is less than 20 millimeters of mercury, this is also indicative of poor tissue perfusion and is also used as the decision point to begin CPR. Studies have shown that it is safe to perform CPR on VAD patients without dislodging the VAD itself. If it is in the immediate postoperative period after VAD implantation, be sure to follow your own institutional guidelines, as some centers will prohibit CPR in the first week or two after VAD implantation. If you are starting CPR on a VAD patient, you should follow ACLS protocols as you would for any patient and be sure to contact the local VAD team for expert consultation. It is safe to use ACLS vasoactive medications to resuscitate VAD patients, and it is safe to use external cardioversion in cases of unstable cardiac rhythms. It is important to assess for complications commonly associated with VAD patients, including stroke, GI bleeding, and sepsis from VAD infections. Remember the H's and T's, as well as other cardiac complications, including VT and VF. Of note, all VAD devices have preset low flow alarms, which can distract clinicians. This alarm will occur when patients are in shock and have low blood pressure. This does not mean that there is a VAD malfunction. It indicates that there is decreased flow of blood through the VAD, which can occur during shock or circulatory collapse. In summary, assessment of an unresponsive patient with a VAD who has poor perfusion can be broken down into three main parts. First, assessment of the VAD by checking the controller and listening for the hum over the chest. Next, assessment of the patient using a Doppler device to check blood pressure. Finally, proceeding with CPR and ACLS protocols as indicated by the blood pressure or end-tidal CO2. Remember to treat reversible causes and other common VAD complications, such as bleeding, stroke, and infections.